You try doing a serious story about cow farts and cow burps, but it is a real problem. The emissions from cows producing methane gas. It's hurting the environment, and they say it also is contributing to climate change. It may not sound like much, but that was a cow burp. Livestock, particularly cows, produce an extraordinary amount of greenhouse gas emissions, 25 times greater than carbon dioxide.
So we're trying to combat that, you know, the negative impacts of animal agriculture on the environment with positive contributions.
This because a cow has four stomachs. Here on the farm, researchers at Wolf's Neck in Freeport studying ways to reduce cow emissions to help save the planet. Much of it revolves around altering the cow's diet.
The seaweed would be a small portion of the animal's diet.
That's right, we're talking about feeding cows seaweed. Scientists across the world now already on it, testing seaweeds of all kinds.
In Australia, for instance, with other species of seaweeds, they use more the red seaweeds. Altogether, it seems to be a strategy to mitigate methane.
Even small amounts of dried seaweed introduced into a cow's diet can cut methane gas by as much as 99%. Out in the pasture, we visit the environmental monitoring station, where there's all kinds of equipment, air quality monitors, wind monitors, even cameras.
It's all being digitally analyzed.
Dorn Cox is a research coordinator at Wolf's Neck. Alongside Andre Brito, an associate professor at UNH, they're working to come up with data that could help craft the perfect cow diet to help reduce those methane gas emissions. Rick Kersberg from UMaine is also in on the project.
So we're trying to improve sustainability of a livestock industry in the Northeast, and adding seaweed to that diet, or if that's one of the components that does that, that's great.
It turns out 90% of the methane comes from a cow's burp rather than gas from the other end of the cow.
Part of it is changing the diet and often, as you heard, using supplements that may be part of our existing environment.
And what better place to study this than here at Wolf's Neck, a 600-acre farm right on the ocean.
And that's really what we're trying to do, is to find a way to improve local resources, whether that's seaweed, whether that's a grass crop that they consume, or other, you know, feed that they're able to grow in the Northeast.
They're also studying how much or how little seaweed needs to be introduced into the cow's diet to produce that desired effect. And there are studies underway from the coast of Maine all the way to Australia. In Freeport, Jim Keithley, WMTW News 8.